以下节目是由加州审计局特约播映。观众朋友晚上好，欢迎收看商界纵横，我是 Mina 李世平。那加州呢，在每十年的联邦人口普查之后呢，需要重新的划分国会、参议院、议会和州平税委员会等地区。在这一节的商界纵横，我们很荣幸的邀请到加州平税加州审计局的公共关系总监 Margarita Fernandez 来到节目当中，他将会为大家介绍亚裔选民申请成为2020公民选区重划委员会委员的重要性。Hi, Margarita, welcome to Business and Lifestyle.
Oh, thank you for having me here, Rena.
Yeah, so first, I would like to know the 2020 Citizens Redistricting Commission. Like, how do you define, why we have that in the first place?
Okay, well, every 10 years after the census is taken,when we know where the population has shifted, California, just like every other state, will go through the process of redrawing district lines from where we elect our representatives, the state senate, the state assembly, the state board of equalization, and also the congressional representatives as well. So the Citizens Redistricting Commission in California, is the body that's charged to redraw those district lines. And so what happens is, you know, one area might have grown tremendously while another area got smaller. And so by redrawing the lines, we are defining those districts, those boundaries, so everybody has the same number. So all the districts have reasonably the same number of population in each district. And so when we elect our representatives, they will have the same voice in making laws, in making changes. But those lines that are drawn really define where our representatives come from. And the Citizens Redistricting Commission in California is the entity that will redraw those lines.
Mm-hmm. So why do they play an important role in the future of California?
Well, what happens is, since it happens every 10 years, we're actually in the process right now of selecting the Citizens Redistricting Commission. It'll be a 14-member commission, it'll be independent, and it's important because the lines that they redraw, and they'll have 1 year to redraw the lines, those lines will stay in place for the next 10 years. Mm-hmm. The maps that are drawn, or the districts that they define, will define where our representatives come from, and that those representatives, or we will use those maps in the year 2022 when we start the elections, and then they'll stay in place for the next 10 years. So that's why it's really important, because it'll stay in place for the next 10 years. Their work will stay in place for 10 years.
Okay, let me translate a little bit. Okay. 那就是刚刚呢 ，Margarita 呢就说呢，根据呢，就是因为加州呢每十年联邦政府会做这个人口普查，然后呢就是加州呢就是每十年这个人口普查之后呢，就是当然每个地区的人口呢可能会有不同的变化。那比如说有些地区呢可能会人口增长，也有些地区可能会减少。那在这个情况之下呢，就会影响未来呢就是代表加州的这个政府，那当中呢就包括有国会了，参议院了，议会了，以及州平税委员会，就是这些地区划分，所以呢就是在这个他们在这个每十年呢就会进行一个叫做公民选区重划委员会，他们呢就是会重新呢就是划分加州的这些选区，那这当然呢会影响以后呢就是亚裔，尤其是华裔参政，然后就是对这个政府的这些重要的决策啊什么就会做很大的影响。So how many people do you pick for the commissioner?
Well, it's a commission made up of 14 members. And actually in 2008, the voters from California passed an initiative that created this independent redistricting commission of 14 members. And it'll be made up of 5 Democrats, 5 Republicans, and 4 that don't belong to either of those two parties, but that they belong to another party, or maybe they haven't indicated a party of preference. So in 2008 was the first time that, we started on this process of creating a commission. it used to, the lines used to be drawn by the members of the legislature and the governor, but what we did with creating this new commission is that we took that responsibility away from the legislature and put it in the hands of an independent citizens redistricting commission.
那刚刚 Margarita 呢就说呢这个从 2008年起呢， 就是之前呢， 其实这个选区重划呢， 是由官员来负责的。 那2008年起呢， 就是加州呢， 就是选出了这个， 就所谓的这个公民选区重划委员会。 那 当中呢就有14个委员， 那这14个委员呢， 就是在你们当中， 就是民众当中呢， 就挑选出来。 那中间呢， 就包括有5位共和党， 5位民主党， 以及5位的中立人， 4位的中立人士。 那这4位的中立人士 就是无党派的。 Okay, so talking about the participation of Asian Americans. So how many Asians were represented 10 years ago?
Oh, so 10 years ago, the commission had 4 Asian Pacific Islanders from the Asian Pacific Islander group. They had 3 Latinos, they had, there was 1 Native American, and the others were white.
Oh, very good.
Yes, very good.
那10年前呢，这个加州选区重划委员会呢，就是当中呢就有4位亚裔，那当中呢也包括有来自湾区的代表。 So this year, talking about how many people have applied so far?
So we have close to 18,000 that have applied, and I know that might sound like a lot, but when the commission was created, the authors of the initiative really wanted it to be a commission that was diverse and reflective of California. So right now we have close to 18,000. Of those 18,000 applications, about 8% are coming from the Asian Pacific Islander group. So we talked earlier about how this is the largest growing population. So we'd really like to see some of those numbers. We'd really like to see applications from all communities in here.
What's the percentage of Asian Pacific Islander population in California?
In California, oh gosh, that's a tough question. But I think of the total population, I think about 15% come from the Asian Pacific Islander group.
So it's over 15%, right?
Yes, a little over the 15%. And right now, if we're looking at the population in, or the applications that have been submitted so far, about 8% are from the Asian Pacific Islander group.
那加州呢，就是华裔亚裔的选民呢，就是占了大概15.3%，但是呢，就是申请成为这个委员会的人数呢，才3%，就是包括所有的亚裔，所以这个比例上来说呢，就是亚裔的申请人呢，就是偏低。So who qualify to be the commissioner?
Okay, to be a commissioner, there's a few things. Number one, we talked earlier about how the redistricting process used to be done by the politicians. And when the authors created the initiative, they really wanted to keep the politics out of the commission. So to be eligible, you have to have voted at least 2 in the last 3 statewide general elections. And you also had to have been affiliated with your party for the last 5 years continuously. And we're looking for people with strong analytical skills, the ability to be impartial, and an appreciation for California's diversity.
那 Margarita 呢就说呢，就大家如果要成为委员的话呢，就是条件呢就是。 当然，您要是这个注册选民，然后呢，在过去呢曾经投票2次，那当然呢也要有很强的分析力。So how to apply? We are running out of time.
Okay, it's an online application process. The initial process application will end August 19th. You just go to our website, shapecaliforniasfuture.auditor.ca.gov. First, the application takes about 5 to 10 minutes to complete, and then after that, we'll notify the applicant and let them know if they qualify to be on the commission, and then what the next step of the process is.
Mm-hmm. So earlier you mentioned there are 18,000 applicants mm-hmm. already. So maybe I'll assume by the end, because the deadline is August 18th, and it's tomorrow, right?
No, yes, August 19th, tomorrow.
Yeah, so people can still apply on the 19th.
Yes, mm-hmm. until 5 o'clock, they can still
until
apply.
Until 5 o'clock. 那正如 Margarita 所说的, 这个呢就是亚裔参选, 就是参加成为这个委员, 非常的重要 因为呢, 就是这样的, 才能让您的声音呢, 就是让大家知道, 然后呢, 也可以参与这个选区的重划, 对未来华裔参政呢, 亚裔参政呢, 也会有很大的影响, 因为呢, 就是, 越多亚裔参与呢, 就是被选中的几率呢, 也会更加的高, 那如果大家有兴趣参加的话呢, 就是, 可以上这个网站, 网址呢, 就是 shapecaliforniasfuture.auditor.ca.gov 那我们现在呢进入一段广告